Hi, this is me Bilal Malik from microcontrollerslab.com. If you are watching my video first time, then let me give you a brief introduction. I am Bilal Malik. I am embedded system engineer. I write technical articles on microcontrollers, power electronics and microcontroller based projects, power electronics based projects. If you want to learn microcontrollers, power electronics, I recommend you to visit my website microcontrollerslab.com. And agenda of today's video is about the project how to design electronic lock using PIC microcontroller. So let's start with a definition of electronic lock. Electronic lock is anything is any lock which use electronics or digital electronics, but in this project we are using a microcontroller to provide a password protected system for our electronic lock. For example, you have come across many electronics lock which used some kind of digital display and some kind of keypad to input a password, then this lock will be open. For example, there are many examples of electronic microcontrollers based electronic lock. In electrical engineering applications, you can use in numerous projects. For example, you have some kind of sensitive project and you want only authorized person to open it or close it, and so you can make it password protected by adding a password system. So there are many electronics projects or electrical power electronics project where you need which are sensitive ones, so you can protect them by using a password protected system. So In this project, electronic lock using PIC microcontroller, I have designed electronic lock. Let me give you a brief overview of it. So, in this project, we are using PIC 16F877A microcontroller. We have interfaced a keypad with PIC microcontroller, a 16x2 LCD with microcontroller. This is oscillator circuit, and we are, instead of using any kind of relay or anything, we are just using LED. We are connected LED with port A of PIC microcontroller, and this is for reset circuit. If you don't know how to interface LCD with microcontroller, keypad with microcontroller, or LED with microcontroller, I recommend you to go to my website microcontrollerslab.com, and you will find many examples and many tutorials on PIC microcontroller. My system is little bit slow, so if you don't know how to interface keypad, LCD, LED with the PIC microcontroller, I recommend you to go to my website and go to tutorials page. It will take some time to load. There is no issue with my website, but my system is little bit slow. So click on tutorials, you will find. Here you click on PIC microcontrollers. So here you will find a list of PIC microcontrollers tutorials. So watch these tutorials. I strongly recommend you to watch these tutorials, because without understanding of LCD interfacing, keypad interfacing, LED interfacing, you will not be able to learn this project completely. So here is a complete list. For example, in this article I have written introduction and features of PIC 16F877A microcontroller, and similarly electromechanical range interfacing with microcontroller, output coupler interfacing, 7 segment display interfacing, PWM interfacing, serial communication, and servo motor interfacing, stepper motor interfacing, keypad interfacing. And similarly, if you click on next page, you will find LCD interfacing, etc. So let's start with basic working of this project. In this project we have used a keypad, and we have stored a default password in a microcontroller, and that default password is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Whenever someone pressed a correct password, for example 1, 2, 3, 4, which is the default stored password in microcontroller, LED will turn on. If password is incorrect, LED will remain off. LCD will show the pressed value of the input value of password, and similarly, if password is incorrect, LED will remain off. If password is correct, LED will be on. So let's start the simulation. This circuit is designed in Proteus. If you don't know how to use Proteus, I have already posted video lectures on Proteus, so just go to Proteus tutorials. This is a complete series on Proteus tutorials. You can watch these tutorials. After watching these video tutorials, you will hopefully able to design circuits in Proteus. So here, when I start the simulation, LCD is asking enter 4-digit password. So when I enter 1, 2, 3, and for example, if someone don't know the password, he will enter incorrect password 5. As LCD showing access denied and LED is off. Now again, LCD is asking enter 4-digit password. Let's now entering 1, 2, 3, and 4, and this time LCD showing access granted, and you can see LCD is on. So this is the basic working of a password protected system, and more advancement can be made in this project by using AAP ROM to add the functionality of password change. But if you want to add this functionality, just email me on my email address, or you can contact me by going to my website at this page, contact us. The code for this project is written using micro C compiler for PIC, because we are using PIC microcontroller. And let me give you a brief review of this code. These are just the variables we are using in this project. For example, you had seen this string on LCD, access granted, and these are just the initializations. These lines are used to set LCD. For example, microcontroller don't know to which page, which port we have connected LED. So we are telling the microcontroller through these lines, we have connected a port B with LCD, or either we have connected LCD with port B, and also defines the port numbers. So I strongly recommend you to watch tutorials on PIC microcontroller before doing this project by going to my website and the PIC microcontrollers, because you will never ever be able to design this project if you don't know how to interface LCD, how to interface keypad. So these are the commands for LCD, and similarly these are the commands for keypad interfacing. And after that, this is the main part of this program. For example, when microcontroller read this code, first microcontroller when microcontroller reach this point, it will ask to enter code 4 times. to enter keypad four times because length of password is 4 digits. After that, microcontroller will compare these inter values with the default stored password, which is 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if password is correct, microcontroller will turn on the LED. If password is incorrect, microcontroller will turn off the LED and display the message 4. Message 4 is access denied. So this is not the difficult task, and you can if you want to add the functionality of password change. For example, if someone accidentally came to know about your password, then you have to change this password. You can also add the functionality of password change by using double AP ROM by storing the value of password, default password in AP ROM, and also adding the functionality to change these double AP ROM values. So for that purpose, you have to learn how to use AP RAM of double AP RAM of PIC microcontroller. I have also posted article on double AP RAM. You can learn about double AP ROM by going to tutorials and on PIC microcontrollers. So I recommend you to read. I have also written a complete article on electronic lock using PIC microcontroller. You can go to my website, and here is a link. I have also given a link of electronic lock using PIC microcontroller article link in the description of the description of this video. So you can find a link of this article also from the description. So one last thing, if you want to subscribe, if you want to get all my future post notification into your email box, then kindly subscribe to my blog by entering your email address here. You will, after entering your email address, you will receive activation email. After clicking on activation link, your subscription will be activated, and you will receive all my future articles in your email. Thank for watching this video.